everybody has one question, and that is, how can we improve our speaking? We know grammar, but still we cannot speak. We know how to write, still we cannot speak. So from day one I have been telling you that the only way of speaking is by speaking yourself. If you listen, you cannot learn to speak. Your ability improves, your language improves. If you read, your grammar, vocabulary, all things improve. But you will never learn to speak unless you speak yourself. So many people from, I think from morning today, at least 50 people have asked me over mail, can you tell us some ways of speaking? All the ways of speaking are already there in the videos which they are seeing. Because they don't know me, they have seen some video or they have seen many videos and then they are sending a mail to me. Which means that if I tell you in 1 hour that you have to do these things, nobody does it. After listening for that 1 hour, they immediately take out email and say, Madam, please tell us how to speak English. What did I do for 1 hour? For many hours, I said only one thing, and that is the varieties of ways in which you can speak. But by listening to those varieties of ways, it is not enough to speak. You have to try out those varieties. 1% of people who attend those, you know, thousands and thousands of people who have been attending IMPACT, I think 1% of people listen to the videos and they practice. 99% does not practice. Now you have to tell me in which group you are there. Are you in that 1% or are you in that 99%? So, the secret is not with me. The secret is not that I have to be there with you for the rest of your life and teach you English. The secret is within you. You might have heard of Swami Vivekananda saying, all power is within you. All power means power to speak English also. That power is already within you. How will you do? By going on practicing, you will bring out that power. He also said that nobody can be taught anything. We can only help you to learn. So my role is only to help you to learn. Yesterday we saw, no, two helping verbs. Very often they don't do main work. The main work is done by somebody else. Only helping is done by these verbs. So today we have come to the third of the primary auxiliary verbs. This also is a helping verb. Yesterday we did to be, then we did to have. Very important verbs. If you open any page of English, you will find be and have are there everywhere. Now we come to do, not so common, but useful. While doing pronouns, I told you that if you want to underline any noun or any pronoun, you have to use the word myself. Like that, if you want to give emphasis to any verb, for noun we use pronoun, for verb we use verb. So that is the first use of the word to do. To do is used to say that, you know, you are doing some work, but you are also emphasizing that you are doing that work. If I say, are you practicing English? So you say, we do practice or we did practice. Practice is the verb. Do means yes, insist. That is 1% only. I told you already. 99% we will say, we don't practice. Again, the idea is the negative. So we can make with the verb do, we can make emphasis. We can also use it for negative. we can use it for question. These are all verbs where you have a main verb. It is not like be and have, where they have lexical use also. Yesterday I showed you one column where the verb is used as a main verb. No other verb is there in the sentence. For do, we don't have like that. One mistake is used, is made while using do. Very often, I hear people saying, we do a mistake. We do a mistake or we did a mistake. That do or did is not the correct word. Mistake collocates with make. So you have to say, I made a mistake, not I did a mistake. Many people say, I do a job. Do a job does not mean working in for salary. You know, if you are employed and you say, I'm doing a job, that is not correct English. Doing a job means small work is there. You finish it. What are you doing after the class? I have to do some job. That means only today you will go to Sultan Bazaar, you will buy something, do a job. That is it. But if you are working every day in a factory, in a company, in a school, in a college, that is not called doing a job. That is called I am working. So you say I am working in a college, I am working in this place, I am working. So these are the uses of do which are not correct. This is called collocation. So if you go to Google search and do, say collocation of the word do, then you will find full list of words. You will say mistakes of collocation of the word do, you will find full list. In this way you can improve your English. Somebody was asking yesterday that I make mistakes in using English, how to correct my own mistakes. You speak, you record, but you can't correct. The reason is because you have not first built up correctness. You must first build up your accuracy. Then only you can do better. So the more you read, the more you listen, the more you practice, your accuracy gets built up. So whenever we come across these mistakes, if you go to any site which says common errors in English, you will get thousands of sentences, not one or two sentences. But after reading those sentences, again students make same mistakes. When they read the sentence, they understand, oh, very good, I have understood. Then again they make a mistake. The reason they make a mistake is because they are not practicing. Suppose you see common errors, there are 1,000 sentences. Don't read all 1,000, read 5. For those 5, you practice 100 times for 5 days. Go on practicing that. The word comes to you, I do a mistake, you say no, do a mistake is wrong. Again you say, I make a mistake, I make a mistake, I make a mistake. That means you are going on repeating the same thing. If you notice how children learn to speak, I am telling you again and again, natural way of learning. You will find if you teach them a new word, they go on repeating that word. They don't say it once. They say it 100 times. You get bored, the child doesn't get bored, because by repetition we are learning it correctly. And that repetition is what all of you need to do. Unless you are able to do this, your English does not improve. You might attend hundreds of courses. You might join, you know, spoken English classes for 1 month, 2 months. No improvement comes, because in a class, you are only getting some ideas. Real practice comes in your life. Suppose you have friends in this group, you practice with those friends. If you don't have, like yesterday he asked, if we don't have a friend, what do we do? We practice with ourselves. No need to wait for outsiders. No need to wait for others. If you find somebody who speaks English better than you, speak with them always. They might laugh at your mistakes, but doesn't matter. If you find somebody who speaks less English than you, speak to that person also, because by looking at somebody's mistakes, you can learn better English. We can learn from everywhere, not only good people, but also people who are not as good as we are. Do you get this point? Therefore, practice is most important. I'm telling you this every day. The reason is because I feel that those who say we don't know English, or those who listen to 5 hours of lecture and then tell me, please tell me how to learn English. For all those people who are watching the videos, my answer is that I have no more ideas. I have given you all my ideas. Why did I give you so many sentences? Because last time when we did grammar exercises for impact, that time there was no time to give sentences. So now people want to learn basic English. Today also 5 mails came saying, tell us basic English, tell us beginner's English. So although here it is written spoken English class, this is not a spoken English class. This is a class of language drill. First slide I showed you, I don't know if you remember. It is called language drill. This is called language drill. I'm making you practice. Have you seen? This is like, you know, the nursery class where the teacher says A and all the students say A like that. Are we not doing the same thing? Now you might feel very bad by saying, oh, I'm so grown up. Why am I doing this? I might feel bad that I teach in the university. Why should I do this drilling? Because it is only through this language drill that we are able to get the basic language for beginners. Beginners, 5 days you get. Then you go on drilling yourself. You don't have to wait. You don't have to attend another course. You go and do it. So this is not only for those 20 or 40 who are attending. This is for all those millions who are saying, please give ideas. We want beginner's English. Those who know good English also are interested in beginner's English, because they reached a level where they have missed out the foundation. If foundation is not good, then the building cannot stand. You know, the building will fall down. The bridges keep falling down because foundation is not good. So we need to build the foundation. This kind of a drill, when you do language drill, it is a foundation. So that is why I keep telling you, I have told you, I think, you know, if you haven't seen these videos of impact, go back and see. You will get all those suggestions which I gave. I said, read every day, 1 paragraph, 10 times. Listen every day, 5 minutes, 10 times you listen. Same passage, you go on listening. That is the drill. You know, if we do that, then we build up a storehouse of knowledge. Once we have knowledge of correct English, then we don't make mistakes. Otherwise, we make mistakes even if we study fragments like vocabulary, pronunciation, grammar, punctuation, spelling, still we make mistakes. So that is why the drill is helping you in all these aspects. You know, when I told you about apostrophe, I was telling you about punctuation. You see, punctuation marks are there. Every sentence there is a full stop. When I told you about neighbor, B-O-U-R and B-O-R, then I told you about spelling. These are all parts. I'm mentioning the grammar, but everything in language is being practiced by this drilling. Okay? Shall we do now? So the first is emphasis. Emphasis means to give importance. So you say, please come to Kachiguda. Suppose somebody tells you. So you say, I know the way to Kachiguda. That person doesn't believe. He says, no, 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 you have to go right, then you have to go left, then you have to go straight. Then you want to insist that you know. Know is the verb here. So how to say with more emphasis, with more force, with more conviction that you know the way, the word know has to be emphasized. We cannot, in speaking, I told you already, we cannot stop and say, please wait, no, I want to underline. In spoken English, that's not possible. Therefore, we need a word. For noun, for verb, we have emphasizing words. Because nouns and verbs are the most important part of the sentence. So, I told you, noun, pronoun, emphasis is with the word S-E-L-F. So, myself, ourselves, yourself, this is emphasizing. Same word emphasizing has come today. Now emphasis is on the verb. So we have the sentence, I do know the way to the office. Somebody is questioning you that, do you know, can you come to the office alone? Should I send some escort, somebody to guide you to the office? They said, no, I do know the way. Insisting, telling that way. So that column is for emphasis. Then negative, I do not know the way to the office. We do not have the form, I know not. You know, for all helping verbs, not can be added together with it. But for all main verbs, lexical verbs, the word not cannot be added to the verb. That is a rule we have to remember. So, any main verb you use, you cannot say, I sit not. You say, I do not sit. You don't say, I study not. You say, I do not study. All the time, we are using the word do not for making negative do or does or did. Depending on the tense, we use the negative form. Question also. Verbs cannot be used as question words. Yesterday I told you, we can use be verbs for question verbs. We can use have verbs for question verbs. Do can be used for question. Verbs cannot be used for question. I live in Hyderabad. Question cannot be live you in Hyderabad. We don't have that form. The word live doesn't have question word. Then you have to introduce a new verb. And that is a helping verb. Do you live in Hyderabad? You understand? So, do has these three functions. It does not have a lexical function. Always, wherever you are using do, you are using it in helping function. So, these three functions, if you remember, you won't make mistake. So, when you say, I do a mistake, you are using do as a lexical verb. We don't have. We have to replace it with make. Make is a verb, you know, which can be used here. It is a full verb. So, it is not a helping verb. Suppose you want to say, I do make a mistake. That is correct English. Do make means you are stressing make. Or, I do not make a mistake. Do you make a mistake? But not, I do mistake. I do mistake. I hear it hundreds of times every day. We don't do a mistake. We make a mistake. The difference is between do and make. Okay? If you listen to this sentence once, you won't remember. Again tomorrow you'll forget it and you'll say, I do a mistake. So what you have to do? You have to go on repeating this to yourself like a mantra. You know how we do mantras? Many of you have by heart, you know, 108 lines of Vishnu Sahasranam, from memory I can recite, no problem. But when it comes to simple mistakes, we make mistakes. We have a powerful memory, but we don't use that memory for English. I hope you are able to understand. Please repeat after me. I do know the way to the office. Okay, now notice, I'm pronouncing the same word T-H-E. Where is that boy? Pronunciation. He hasn't come today. Notice the pronunciation. I'm writing T-H-E. E. Two times the word is there in this sentence. I'm pronouncing first time the way because it is consonant. Immediately after T-H-E, the sound is W. W is a consonant sound. So, the way. But office is a vowel sound. A-E-I-O-U, vowel sounds. Okay? There are 20 vowel sounds in English. You can learn those also. But that only those who are doing master's degree in English learn. Because they are the teachers of English. You don't need to learn. Now, office sound is O, vowel sound. So, I say the. I don't say the. I say the. So, you have to make the difference. All vowel sounding words, T-H-E becomes the, and E. The British variety of T-H is pronounced by putting your tongue in between your teeth. So, if I pronounce it like that, it will be the and the. But such a sound we don't have. Such putting tongue in between our teeth sounds we don't have. Therefore, we put our tongue behind our teeth. We say the tongue is here, the tongue is here. But one is a and one is e. Are you able to get this difference? So, please repeat again. I do know the way to the office. Did you get the difference? Okay. He does work hard every day. The word is work. Work. And k. Not work. Did you understand? Although r is written, r is not given so much importance. So, he does work hard every day. We did practice English regularly. So, do and does are present tense forms. Do is used with I do, we do, you do, they do. He, she and it, we say does. S form. S form is the singular form. Singular third person. Did is same for everybody. I did, you did, he did, she did, we did. All are did. Past tense. Again, you have do. I do listen to what my elders tell me. They did love their neighbors and fellow human beings. Now, the negative form. Again, short form is informal. Please remember, the apostrophe form is a short form. Apostrophe has one use and that is possessive. I already showed you. You know, my father's son, my grandfather's son, all those things we had one chart. That is called possessive. Now, here apostrophe is used for omission. Omission means removing something. Suppose you want to put today's date, you put one apostrophe and you say 19. That apostrophe means 2019. This year is 2019. For 100 years, it will be 20. So, we need not repeat. We put apostrophe, that means something is missing. That something is 2000. But suppose after 500 years you see this date, apostrophe 19, you don't know is it 1919, is it 1819, is it 2019? Nobody knows because that is missing. So, here also O is missing, therefore we are putting that apostrophe. That is only informal. Informal writing, informal speaking, we don't use these forms. But in informal speaking and writing, if you don't use them, then your English is not good. You know, usually we learn spoken English also for informal speaking. We might speak to people of our age, of our peers, our groups, our friends, colleagues. Then you might have to informal English. You know, suppose your boss is your best friend, in the office you speak formally, at home you speak informally, then you have to use the short forms. If you don't use the short form, then it is not considered as good English. So where informal has to be used, use informal. Where formal has to be used, use formal. Don't make the confusion. We do not know her. We don't know her. He does not live here now. He doesn't live here now. They did not like this dish. They didn't like this dish. Dish here implies food item, you know, something which you are eating. So dish doesn't mean the plate on which you serve. Nobody is going to eat that. They are only going to eat the food that is there. So dish is some particular kind of preparation. Now the question form. Look at all the words which have nouns. The first column, if you look, do, know. So know is the main verb. Does, work. So work is the main verb. Did, practice. So practice is the main verb. Do, listen. So listen is the main verb. Did, love. Love is the main verb. Here also, do not know. Know is the main verb. Then does not live. Live is the main verb. Did not like. Like is the main verb. So all of them have to have a verb. The word do is not going to be alone in a sentence and be correct. If you keep do alone in a sentence for verb function, that sentence is wrong. You can immediately know this is a wrong sentence. Do you travel abroad? Question form. Do you travel abroad? Does he go to school every day? Did he ask you anything? Did you follow? I hope all of you understood how do has to be used. This is a very important verb, but it is not so common as the first two verbs we studied yesterday. This importance I am trying to explain. Now all of you read it on your own quickly once. Start.
They didn't like.
Did he ask you anything?
Yes, see, today your questions are very good. You are getting the correct intonation how to ask a question. It should not be flat, it should be above. Now, these are the three verbs to be, to have, to do. These are called primary auxiliary verbs because primary, you know, main, basic verbs.